Before movies were invented, the concept of pirates was vicious, murderous, bad people, villains. But the movies started to turn them into handsome swashbucklers who always get the girl and the riches and all of this.
So, Dr. Haviser, you know, the document Welcome to Slaveryland, how has this impacted your career and how do you want to move forward from this?
My presentation actually was the closing concepts of the 20th century and how innovations in technology have actually gone parallel to societal shifts relating to perceptions of piracy behavior and illicit activities. Mm-hmm. And that started then, but it has multiplied, it has grown. And as transistors became microchips, we ended up reaching the level of computers that now are taking imagery and concepts like piracy and villains as heroes, and it's converting it into societal norms. And my concern that I was presenting in this paper is that as, well, the example that we had these movies, the Errol Flynn movies, the swashbucklers and such, but then we start getting into the Cecil B. DeMille movies, we start getting into actual real life cases of Bonnie and Clyde and the Dillinger. But what is happening now is that piracy and piracy behavior has become so popular. It's fun. It's children's games. We end up with villains become heroes, then heroes become leaders, and then the AI leads the leaders. Right. And so I'm concerned at the trajectory where we're going, where illicit behavior is being glorified. Mm-hmm. And think about this. We have children dressing up as pirates. But what about if they understood what real pirates were? Would they be so happy to dress up and put an image of a pirate on their shirt if in fact they realized that they were slavers and murderers? So it is, I think we've reached a very dangerous point of the public mind being molded by the technologies. The amount of local heritage that's educated in the school system is not up to where it should be. I wrote the very first school textbooks for about indigenous peoples of Curaçao, as an example. We didn't have anything in the schools, really, about the indigenous peoples. I think there are a couple of key messages that I was trying to convey. And I remember, it was 20 years ago, so there have been a lot of changes since then. But 20 years ago, I think what I was seeing is the commodification, taking heritage, artifacts or stories of heritage, and turning them into products to be sold, to be commodified. That is clearly not a healthy trajectory. One of the things we need to really think about, Rupert, is that slavery dehumanized the Africans horribly. But slavery, the practice of slavery, also dehumanized the enslavers themselves. It made them callous to the brutality that they were implementing. So slavery dehumanized both parties in this context.